Hi and welcome back. In case you're new to the channel, my name's Samuel and this is all about composition, orchestration and cinematic music production. So if that's something you enjoyed, you came to the right place. Now this is the second part of a series that I'm doing about the BBC Symphony Orchestra Core library from Spitfire Audio that I've been using quite a lot. As I've already mentioned in my first episode, I'm not a huge expert or anything of like that, but I've been using the library for quite a while and I think I figured out its strengths and its weaknesses, and I kind of figured out how I like to set it up and use it in my projects. It's a staple of my template and I like to walk you through all of the sections in detail. In the first episode, which you can find linked somewhere over here, I go through the interface in depth and strings, so we're going to skip all of that part. We're going to have only a very brief look at the interface to figure out what's different for the woodwind sections. And then this episode is probably going to be praise and praise and praise, because the woodwinds is what I believe the most beautiful part of this library. So without further ado, let's move to the door and let's have a look together. As a basis and as a showcase, because I've used the BBC Orchestra a lot, I'm taking my IFMC scoring, where we had a very gentle melody going on, and I showcased it only with the string sections in episode one. We're going to listen to an interpretation or a translation of that melody to the woodwind section, how it picks up in a second repetition, and then also listen to how they sound together and how they complement each other. Before we do that, let's go through the instruments you get in detail, because there is something that is different about the woodwind section from the string section, and that is that you actually get solo instruments. And boy, oh boy, are they lovely. So those are the solo flutes. And what you can hear is, first of all, as usually, I turn off the reverb, because I do like using my own stage reverb. So you're getting full dry sound now. And again, we have a vibrato. So let's listen to the vibrato. I'm going to turn on the flute really loud now. As with the string section, it's basically an on and off with a bit of a smooth transition in the center. I still like to control it with one of my CC controllers. So if you have a look over here, this is the CC controller for me to control the vibrato. So now it's off and now it's on. And I do use this for effects, particularly when I'm playing solo melodies, but let's keep it on for now. So we have legatos, it's called extended because, as with the strings, you get the ability to play very short notes and it's going to be respected by the instrument. Then we have longs, which is classic sustain, so you can play polyphonic. Something like that. Then we've got trills in major and minor second. And then we have the short notes, where very nice, we have staccatissimos. We have tenutos. Marcatos. And very nice articulation, flutter. Cool effect. And multi-tongue, which comes in variations, because if you listen carefully, so this is the variation when we are all to the left, so it's three notes, doo, doo, doo. But if we move it all the way up, we get doo, 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 doo. So that's five, and somewhere in between in the middle we have four. See, that's a really nice detail that's in the BBC Symphony Orchestra, both in the woodwinds but also in the brass section, and it comes in really handy. So I'm really in love with the solo flute, and if I may say, the only thing that I don't like about it, and Again, now not complaining about it, but it's something that bothers me, and I get why they do that, is I only have one mic position. And it's kind of, I have the sound of the flute, solo flute, pretty much in place. And I can't really move close to it. So I never get the detail that I really want to. Now, we also have flutes in Ensemble of Three, and we have the exact same articulations. There's instantly more power and also a little bit more brightness in the sound, as we have three players. We have many longs. I'm not going to play all of the sound specifically. The flutter. Very nice. So you have a few effects. By the way, if you're enjoying this video and you find the content useful, it would be great if you could leave a like. Let's have a look at the piccolo flute, which comes with a bit different articulations, because besides having very lovely legato, long, very nice staccatos, it has rips, which also have variations. So it gets longer or short, but the short falls have a short accent, a medium accent, and a long accent on the first note. And I think that's really, really lovely, very useful. I use them a lot to accent, oftentimes the end of a woodwind run, like I go, and then I have the piccolo flute take over with a rip and things like that. It's really, really useful. And then, we have solo oboes, which I'm not a huge fan of the oboe. I'm really sorry, oboe players out there, oboists, I guess. I just never, I don't know. I have to apologize. I think I just never understood the sound of the oboe. I think it makes lovely textures. But it's also, I don't know. I always have a hard time figuring out where and how to use it in my orchestration, and I most of the time end up using it for texture purely, which is most likely very unfair to oboists and to oboes as an instrument, because I'm sure you can do a lot more with that, and it's just me basically not knowing how to orchestrate them effectively. But we have again here all the articulations we expect, like trills and staccatissimos. Things like that. Tenuto. Yeah, we went through all of that. And multitongues. Wonderful. And we've got them obviously also as ensemble. Much more powerful for obvious reasons. Then we have clarinets. I love the solo clarinet. I love the solo clarinet. I really love it. And we have him as an ensemble, which is equally lovely. Has a bit more of a mellow sound because of the ensemble playing. And then we have solo bassoon, which has to be my favorite. I just love bassoons. Same thing with the section. That's it. So that's maybe my only other point where I'd say, so I've already said mic positions would be great for the solo instruments. The only thing is you have everything you need for a symphony orchestra, but not more. So there's no alto flute, there's no bass clarinet. Those things are kind of missing. If that makes sense, although they're not really missing because they're also special, they're extras. And I get why you don't get them in Core. I'm not sure about whether they're actually included in the Pro version. Yeah, I will look that up, and I'll leave that as a comment in the pin below. The exact difference between Core and Pro. Okay, so let's have a look at the piece. I've already loaded in here the strings again, and as a friendly reminder of the melody that we're talking about, I'll play the string section again for you right now. Now, if I solo the woodwinds in the second half, the woodwinds are now basically taking over the role that the strings had in the first repetition of the melody, and they're switching roles with the strings. So the strings are really just giving a bit of rhythmic support, and they have this string run in here in the middle. So you can tell that I really like the short articulations. Very nice. And if we layer it with the strings, helping us provide more texture, more rhythm, we get this. Final thoughts. I love the woodwind section, and that's kind of the place where I'd say I'm actually completely happy with it. If I need more special things, I usually either find it in some kind of free library or I just go, not gonna need that. Let's stick to what I have. And I usually get around very well. Now, I hope you heard how well the strings and the woodwinds blend together to create really the sound of a cohesive symphony orchestra, because that's what it is. That's all for today. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. Let me know your thoughts about the BBC Symphony Orchestra Core if you own it, or if you don't own it and you're considering to buy it. Let me know what you would be specifically interested in. If there's something I missed out that you would like to know, just let me know in the comments. And if you enjoy this format of video and you're curious for the brass section, the percussion section, you should definitely subscribe to the channel, because that's coming up in the next 1 to 2 months. Keep creating.